Hi friends, I am Dr. Arvinder Singh. As we all know that we are going through a tough time. We can call it corona epidemic, and since it is on the large scale, we can call it as corona pandemic, as WHO has mentioned it. Lot of hue and cry is going on because lot of patients are getting infected in India. There are many deaths happening. Lot of confusion is there because government as an emergency measure is placing lot of medical as well as paramedical staff into the corona ward. And when this is happening, doctors are having their point of view, paramedical staff is having their own point of view, and government is having their point of view that what should be done, what are the rights and obligations of the doctors, paramedical staff, and on the other end, what are the rights and obligation of the government. So this video is being made to clear all those confusion and to throw light that in these circumstances, how medical persons should behave and how government should take care of them. I received many a calls from my friends from Uttar Pradesh, from Rajasthan, from government doctors as well as private doctors, that what can be done if government is placing them into corona wards for the duties in the shifts or in for few hours for testing, whatever the measures can be. And many doctors were having the point of view that if they are into the private practice, how they can be forced to do the duties for the government. So this video will discuss about all these aspects, how we will be governed at this time of pandemic of corona, what the law says about this. So we are now governed by Epidemic Disease Act 1897, and the section 2 subsection 1 of Epidemic Disease Act will throw light that when and how government can do something. It gives the power to the government to take special measures and prescribe regulation as to dangerous epidemic disease. What it says, when at any time the state government is satisfied that the state or any part thereof means of it, is visited by or threatened with an outbreak of any dangerous epidemic disease. So when government is satisfied that either it's a whole state or part of it is threatened by dangerous epidemic disease, so who is the deciding authority over here? Who is saying? Who is having the discretionary power? Because many doctors were of the opinion that in their particular city or in that particular zone, there is not much number of cases or no cases at all. So they will not be covered under the Epidemic Disease Act. No friends, this is not the fact, because the discretionary power lies with the government. If government is satisfied, there is no criteria that how government will be satisfied. So if government is satisfied, we have to follow the command of the sovereign. And if state government thinks, again thinks means discretionary power, that ordinary provisions of law for the time being in force are insufficient. If government thinks that the measures which are going on, जो उसके पास में अभी ऑर्डिनरी लॉज एंड रेगुलेशंस थे, वो सफिशिएंट नहीं है, दे आर इनएडिक्वेट टू हैंडल दिस काइंड ऑफ एपिडेमिक, देन व्हाट दे कैन डू? दे कैन प्रिस्क्राइब सच टेम्परेरी रेगुलेशंस टू बी ऑब्जर्व्ड. सो टेम्परेरी रेगुलेशंस कैन बी इम्पोज्ड, एंड देर इज नो डेफिनेशन, देर इज नो टाइम लिमिट ऑफ दोज टेम्परेरी regulation. So it is at the discretion of the government that what kind of temporary regulations they are taking for how much of the time and for whom these temporary regulations are made, for any person or class of person or public. I mean to say, anybody can be asked to do something. So how medical and paramedical staffs are governed by this? Because they belong to a particular class of persons. So what we mean by class? A particular section of community which is having a common factor percolating in them. So medical and paramedical, they are trained for handling the patients. So when they are trained for handling the patients, they belong to a particular class of persons and they are covered under this Epidemic Disease Act. And government may provide regulation for what? To prevent the outbreak of such disease or the spread of it, and may determine in what manner and whom any expenses incurred should be defrayed. So how expenses will be done and all those stuff is also at the discretionary power of the government. You may say that medicos may say, or anybody can say that, oh no, this is an atrocity act and what is this. This is all having a different opinion. I am not here to comment upon the validity or invalidity of any act. It is the power lying with the Supreme Court, our Honorable Apex Court, who will decide that how law should be interpreted. I am here to tell you that what law is.